Hello friends, today we are going to study the new chapter, which is the chapter number 20 in your NCERT book of biology of 11th class, and the chapter states itself neural control and coordination. So as we all know that an organ system which is called the nervous system, it is responsible for control and coordination into the human body. In the human body there is a lot of different type of cells, tissues, organs, organ systems are present, like respiratory system, digestive systems, endocrine system, circulatory system, and all these systems are working together, beta. All these systems are coordinate with the help of nervous system. So nervous system and neural system, it helping in controlling all different type of organ system into the human body, and also helping in coordinating different between different tissues, cells and organs. So today we are going to study about nervous system. Generally when we talk about the human neural system, so in human neural or nervous system, beta, we can differentiate it in three parts. Number one, it is called CNS or central nervous system. The CNS or central nervous system is the kind of neural system which functions or takes working between brain and spinal cord. Okay. The second, it is called PNS or peripheral nervous system. So PNS or peripheral nervous system can be defined as the kind of nervous system which works or perform its action between spinal cord and other body organs and tissues. And the third, when we talk about beta, it is called ANS or autonomous nervous system. So autonomous nervous system is the kind of nervous system which is responsible for maintaining and functioning of reflex action, that means involuntary actions into the body. So these three different type of neural systems are present into the human being. A general account is also given a general account is also given for the concise study of neural system evolution in your NCERT book, beta. So as we talk about in Hydra, it is the simplest type of neural system is present. Hydra, they belong to the group of Coelenterata. So in Hydra, it is a very simplest type of neural system is present. As we grows, as we seen in evolutionary manner, as we go towards from invertebrates to vertebrates, beta. So we can understand that in the group Annelida, when we talk about in earthworm, so here we notice the little complex neural system than previous invertebrates. So here the brain, it is in the form of ganglia is present. It is act like brain in Annelida, especially in earthworm, and this ganglia, they are actually a pair of ganglion, singular word, it is ganglion, beta. So this ganglion, when we talk about, it is going to associated with the two ventral nerve cord, and then they are going to be transferred into whole body. So in that manner, the little complex neural system present into Annelida, earthworm. And as we go on, after arthropoda, mollusca, we comes to the vertebrates, and we when we talk about the chordata group vertebrates, so the more complex structure is seen there, where in the fishes the brain is going to be formed there. So when we talk about human being, in the higher mammals, the more complex vertebral more complex neural system is present. So when we talk about the human neural system, as we talk about previously, so in human neural system, In your book, it has given beta. The central nervous system or CNS, it is further divided into two parts. Number one, it is called somatic neural system. And the second one, it is called autonomic neural system. So when we talk about the first one, beta, somatic neural system, it is the kind of neural system, beta, which actually helps in transfer of impulse from central nervous system to the voluntary organs, or we can say voluntary skeletal muscles. Okay, we know that the muscles which are associated to the bones or skeleton, they are known as voluntary muscles. They only perform actions once we desire, we try to make them perform the action, beta. So this somatic neural system, it plays a role as intermediate, and it receives the impulse from central nervous system, and it is going to be transferred that impulse, electric signal, to the voluntary skeletal muscle, beta. Okay, and voluntary organs as well. Excuse me. When we talk about autonomic neural system, so autonomic neural system helps to transfer the impulse from CNS to involuntary smooth muscles. Or we can say involuntary organs. We know that in our respiratory system, in our circulatory system, there are certain organs, certain muscles, the muscles of stomach, gastrointestinal area. So that muscles, they also working, but without our will. These muscles, which are made up of smooth muscles, they are called involuntary muscles. So these involuntary muscles actually working, beta, once they're receiving the impulse from central nervous system through autonomic neural system. Okay, this autonomic neural system further divided into two parts, sympathetic and parasympathetic neural system. So it is this concise manner given in your NCERT book, bachon.